Jerry Hatch was born near Brockville, Ontario in 1922 to Earl and Ethel Hatch. When Jerry was just 5 years old, his father passed away and he moved to his grandparents' farm near Belleville, Ontario.
By the end of elementary school, Jerry's mother took him and the two of them moved into Montreal and primarily to get him a better education. Jerry was forever grateful, of course, for the help he had from his mother. He never forgot it, and he looked after her in her retirement and in her old age.
Jerry won a scholarship to McGill University to study chemical engineering. At the end of his second year, he transferred to metallurgy on the advice of his professor. Despite being hospitalized with pleurisy in his final year, Jerry excelled and graduated at the top of his class in 1944.
After McGill, he spent a little while working at Schwinnigan, and then he really got interested in metallurgy and Dr. Chipman in particular, who was a rare bird working in attached to MIT. It's clear now, I mean, he got his PhD from MIT and moved on then to armor, as we know, and from there he moved on to Sorel with QIT, and for not very many years, but he was there, I think, for about 5 years, became the manager. He then decided that there was a vacuum out there, that he thought there was an opportunity to start a more comprehensive engineering kind of company. And he started looking around, and he found himself talking with W.S. Atkins Partners. Jerry decided and accepted the position to go work for them and be their top guy, their president. And a few years later, I think about 66, 65, he bought the business with, he brought on Tanoskovich and Archie Lamont as shareholders with him. And as, and the rest is history.
His fundamental way of working was to work from strength and to be technically the best in the world. I mean, that he chose that as for himself, and he expected that from his, from others in the company.
He felt that good engineering could change the world, and I think it does.
Jerry really brought to the metallurgical world and the consulting world his ability to bring together technology and business consulting. I think he almost invented that space in Canada.
Jerry inspired many people, and I'm just one of them, by his determination, his intellect, and interest in solving difficult problems. He was very, very innovative.
I never knew anyone else like Jerry who could maintain such an intensive focus on unsolved problems, challenges, or opportunities. He always persisted until the optimum outcome was attained.
His motto was to look after the client's business, and that would look after Hatch's business.
He wasn't just a salesman at all. He let the clients know what was best. He was a great consultant, so he let clients know what worked in his view, what worked and what didn't work, and what he would recommend they're doing, and was pretty forceful about those ideas.
In retrospect, Jerry's philosophy on project management, supported by Ted Noskovich at the time and others, was to do your homework, get all the engineering done up front, and stage a project properly. Having done early studies, and you know, we've got more formal names for them today, but that principle was laid down back in the late 60s, early 70s, and frankly, we're doing the same thing today.
It's so easy to gravitate to project management where you get the whip out and drive people to build a project. And it's not necessarily going to get a good project. Good projects are going to come from doing your homework again and using the latest technologies and the smarts, the people that you hire, the smarts that you have, and then putting this together with a good project management team that gets you to the end product. And I don't think there's any other company in the world that does that better.
He used to say, you got to do your homework. And that phrase has become a mantra for us at Hatch, doing your homework. And what Jerry meant by that, I think, was, yes, you got to know our clients' business. You have to know about their technology, but you also have to know about them as people. And when you put all those together, you typically can help them and support them in what they do and add real value.
What I remember mostly, very, very keen interest in people. He would deal with each one individually and want to get to know them and understand the motivations, and obviously look in our company for people who are motivated and smart to deliver what our clients want.
He had this family culture within the company, and certainly when it was smaller, it was easy. When it got bigger, and when we went around the world, it got bigger, but I think that was something that we were able to take with us.
Every time I saw Jerry, one of the first things he'd ask me is, how's your family? And he'd mention my daughters, both of them by name and my wife by name. He really had a great memory for that, because I think he really cared about the people that worked with him, that were part of the organization, that were part of his life. He demonstrated that many, many times. He was a real people person.
Jerry would often say that we're in the people business. Our asset is people. Look after them.
If there was one thing that I would say that would summarize all the things that he brought to me as an individual and to the company, it was to have a real interest, a real passion for the business and all the aspects that make it important. And I think, you know, in the short time that I worked with him and the many years that I spoke to him, I think that's what he demonstrated to me, was a real driving interest, curiosity, and passion for what we do. And I would hope that everyone at Hatch, you know, a little bit of that rubs off on them.